Dear students, I welcome you all on behalf of TS Academy and your host facilitator with a new topic for discussion, understanding and learning, and that is ozone depletion and its effects. First of all, we must know what is ozone. Ozone is an allotropic form of oxygen consisting of three atoms. Allotropic means sometimes an element exists in more than two forms. So ozone is an allotropic form of oxygen. It is formed in atmosphere by the association with an oxygen atom and an oxygen molecule in the mid of atmosphere. So in the mid of atmosphere, an atomic oxygen combines with a molecule of oxygen and forms a molecule of ozone. It accumulates in the atmosphere, but most of the ozone accumulates in the layer of stratosphere. Location of ozone layer. Ozone layer is present throughout the atmosphere, but its maximum concentration lies in the stratosphere, about 25 to 30 kilometers away from the Earth's surface. This layer of ozone protects the Earth from harmful UV radiations or ultraviolet radiations. Otherwise, they will cause skin cancer. It is like a shield that protects us from harmful radiations. Balance of ozone concentration in atmosphere. Under normal conditions, ozone concentration in stratosphere remains nearly constant through a series of complex atmospheric reactions. Two reactions that maintain balance in ozone concentration are as follows. Number one, oxygen molecule reacts with atomic oxygen and produce ozone. Whereas sometimes ozone reacts with atomic oxygen and produce two molecules of oxygen. So interconversion of oxygen molecules into ozone molecule, and again conversion of ozone molecule into oxygen molecule, is a continuous reaction that is occurring in stratosphere. Formation of ozone in atmosphere. Now let's see diagrammatically the formation of ozone in atmosphere. Here is a molecule of oxygen consisting of two atoms of oxygen. They separate from each other and form two atoms, and this is the atomic form of oxygen. When these atoms separately combine with one more oxygen molecule here, and this atom combines with one more oxygen molecule, two molecules of ozone are formed separately. Now let's see what are the various compounds which are the cause of depletion of ozone layer from stratosphere, or in other words, making a hole in the ozone layer. Chlorofluorocarbon compounds, CFCs. However, chlorofluorocarbons used as refrigerants in air conditioner and refrigerators are the major cause of ozone depletion. These compounds leak in one way or other, escape and diffuse to stratosphere. So chlorofluorocarbon compounds are the main cause of depletion of ozone layer. Chlorofluorocarbon compounds. These are the compounds which are used in refrigerators and air conditioners. By the leakage of these electrical appliances, they escape and reach to the area of stratosphere. and there these chlorofluorocarbon compounds react with ultraviolet radiations, and a bond between carbon and fluorine is broken, and one of the free radical of chlorine is liberated. And this is the main cause of depletion of ozone layer, because this radical is very reactive, and first of all it reacts with ozone and produce a molecule of oxygen and one more compound OCl, which is unstable, and OCl again breaks and an atom of oxygen and one more free radical of chlorine is produced. Atomic oxygens combine together and produce one molecule of oxygen. A single chlorine free radical released by the decomposition of chlorofluorocarbon is capable of destroying up to many lakhs of ozone molecules. Now let's see the difference in the ozone layers which are responsible for the depletion of ozone in atmosphere. Here is ozone layer and there isn't any hole. So the sun rays, ultraviolet radiation, are absorbed by the ozone layer. They are unable to reach to the surface of Earth. Ozone layer, which is about 25 to 30 kilometer away from surface. Now let's see this layer where there is a hole between the ozone layer, or ozone is got under the process of depletion. So depletion of ozone layer by chlorofluorocarbon compound has happened, and now ultraviolet radiations are able to travel toward the Earth. Ozone hole. The region in which ozone layer depletes is called ozone holes. Signs of ozone depletion were first noticed over Antarctica in 1980s and Arctic region in 1990s. Effects of ozone O3 depletion. Even minor problems ozone depletion can cause major effects. Now what are the various effects? Number one, depletion of ozone O3 can cause ultraviolet radiation to reach the Earth, which can cause skin cancer to humans and animals. Number two, decreased ozone layer will increase infectious diseases like malaria. Number three, it can change the life cycle of plants, disrupting their food chain. Number four, it can change wind pattern all over the world, resulting in climate change.